Hi everyone, my name is Steffen from Liqui Moly. Today we're here at FCP Euro in Milford, Connecticut, and we're making a video all about transmission fluids. What are the differences, why you have to use a special fluid for the transmission or the axle in your particular car. I want to start with some myths. Some say there is just one fluid for all, but that's not true. When you talk about a transmission, you first have to see what kind of transmission do you have. Do you have a converter clutch transmission, automatic transmission, manual transmission, or is it a CVT or a dual clutch transmission, or is it even a fluid you need for your axle, front or rear axle in your 4x4 car? Each single system has different requirements to the fluid, so that's why there is not a one-for-all fluid. You need to have a specification on the bottle of the fluid that makes sure that is the right part number for your transmission in your vehicle. Talk about some ATF fluids. ATF, automatic transmission fluids. Why are there so many different ones? Some still say, oh, I was always using the red fluid. Red, that's just the added dye. In the past, 60s, 70s, 80s, typically ATF fluids contained a red dye just for a visible separation between an ATF fluid and a normal hydraulic fluid. It was just a dye added to avoid mistakes in the workshops by the mechanic. So there are different types of ATF fluids. When you look on the label of an ATF fluid, there is always a classification name, the specification. Roughly, the old transmission designs, 4- and 5-speed automatic transmission with a converter clutch, they can be serviced with mainly only one single type of transmission fluid. Specification is Dextron 3 or Ford Merkern that is backwards compatible. So it's relatively easy if you have an older 4- or 5-speed automatic transmission. As soon as it's a 6, 7, 8, 9-speed or even 10-speed transmission, it's a little bit critical and more different because more and more vehicle manufacturers or even the transmission manufacturers require very well-balanced formulations, for example, with exactly the right friction values or exactly the correct viscosity behavior of that fluid. So that's why you should not use the wrong fluid in your modern 6- or more-speed automatic transmission. Typically, most of transmissions from most manufacturers like CF or Getrag or GM, they can be serviced with a Dextron 6 type or Merkern LV type transmission fluid, which for example is a Liqui Moly TopTech ATF 1800. But there are some specialties, for example, vehicle manufacturers like Mercedes-Benz, they still develop and produce their own transmission and they have some different requirements to the fluids. That's why for Mercedes, for example, we have special fluids available which only meet one single specification, which may not be backwards compatible to any other one. So that's why when you're looking for the right transmission fluid for your automatic transmission, doesn't matter if it's an old 4-speed or the latest 9-speed, always use the correct specification, the correct fluid for your car. I'll talk about later how this is easy for you to find the right fluid for your car. So besides an automatic transmission, there are two more kinds of automatic transmissions. One of them is the CVT transmission, which is very common in more the hybrid vehicles, but also have been common in the past at some Volkswagen Audi, the so-called multi-tronic transmission. That's a CVT, a special transmission design, which also has completely different requirements to the fluid than a standard converter clutch transmission. That's why we have special oil for these CVT transmissions. And last but not least, on the automatic transmission side, we have the dual clutch transmissions, DSG transmissions. But there isn't only one oil that covers all. If we talk about a dual clutch transmission, we have to see, is it a dry clutch system or a wet clutch system? So same thing as with all the other ATFs and transmission fluids, always look on the specification. If this fluid you want to use really, really meets all the OEM's given requirements for your vehicle. So that's why there are so many different ATFs or in common automatic transmission fluids. So looking on the label, you may realize they look a little bit different than a common motor oil label. Some have numbers, some have some nice colors on it, some list a SAE viscosity, some not. Important thing on the SAE viscosity on ATF fluids or in general on hydraulic fluid, the SAE viscosity classification is not valid because the viscosity behavior and the viscosity of the oil itself is classified within the performance classification. So that's why you will not see an SAE classification on an ATF fluid or on a CVT fluid, for example. The numbers on Liqui Moly's ATF labels have nothing to do with the performance, it's just the product's name. So it's not the 18 or 1900 is higher than a 1200, it's just the product's name. So that's why you see numbers here and no viscosity here, while on the transmission fluids or axle fluids, you see a SAE viscosity and no fancy number or name on it. But there is even more. Looking underneath your car, you see axles, you see differentials, or you have one of the mainly European manual transmissions built in your car. Therefore, we also need completely different gear oil formulations than on an ATF fluid. And there is also some myths going around. People think API GL5 classification is backwards compatible because 5 is higher than 4 or even 3. So what does it mean, API GL? API, American Petroleum Institute, GL gear lubricant. So that's a classification system for manual transmissions or axles or so-called hypoid systems. Hypoid systems are typically placed at the axles, and the special is on a hypoid system. The power is coming in from the engine and then divided into left and right. So there is a lot of pressure under shear, while in a standard manual transmission, there is also pressure between the teeth, but not that much shear. That means we need different fluid formulations, specialized for this hybrid conditions or for the conditions in a manual transmission. So that's why the API classification is not downwards compatible. Your transmission system needs a well-balanced formulation that meets exactly the requirements for your system. So that's why we recommend you to always use some kind of oil guide when you choose the right lubricant for your transmission. On FCP Euro's website, if you enter your type of car, it automatically puts the right fluid for your vehicle into your basket. That's a safe way to do. Another possibility for you is if you don't know what's the right fluid for your vehicle, just go to Liqui Moly's website, send us emails. We're happy to help you. Sometimes we receive questions if different ATF fluids are mixable with each other. Of course, fluids of the same specification are always mixable. But of course, the full product performance is only guaranteed when they are mixed, used as pure as possible. So if you want to do an automatic transmission fluid change on your vehicle, and if you have access to a flushing device, this is always highly recommended to make sure you get nearly 99 or 100% fluid exchange rate, because automatic transmissions typically are separated into two sides. We have the converter clutch side and we have the gear side. And most in newer vehicles, there is no drain plug on the converter side. So if you do a fluid change only where the oil pan is, you do only half of the job, because the fluid exchange range is nearly less than 50% only. So ideally, you have a flushing device, make sure you get 100% fluid exchange range so the product can perform as much as better, and you even make a proper service. If you have no access to a flushing device, as I mentioned, all the fluids with the same specification are mixable with each other. It's not harmful. You may not just get a full performance when you only drain 50% of the used oil and not 100%. But it's not harmful. Mixing different products together or mixing the rest of the used oil stays in your transmission with the fresh fluid. So when it comes to maintaining or what is the service interval of your ATF fluid, for example, there is also another myth going around. The myth is called lifetime filling. I mean, there is not a clear definition of how long is the lifetime of a transmission fluid. Fact is that most of the modern transmissions, 6 and more speed automatic transmissions, the manufacturer, could be even the transmission manufacturer or the vehicle manufacturer, they have fixed given service intervals for their transmissions. Some manufacturers even require change your DSG fluid already after 25,000 miles, which is very low. Some other manufacturers require to have 40, 50, 60,000 miles oil change interval on their modern converter clutch transmissions. So the age of lifetime filling, that's already older. This myth was created with the older transmissions, but in general, you can say you should change your transmission fluid if there is no fixed given service interval, latest after around 60 to 80,000 miles, or at latest after 6 to 8 years, depending on how hard you ride your car or you pull a heavy trailer all the time. But lifetime is marketing nonsense. Just in case you still have any questions about ATF fluids, transmission fluids in general, don't hesitate to contact us, leave a comment under the video, or contact us on our Liqui Moly website. All these products can be purchased at FCP Euro, of course in their shop and online. Thank you for watching this video and see you next time.